Namaste and welcome. Today, let us talk about schizophrenia. Schizophrenia is a complex mental condition for which there is no single cause. Roughly 1% of the world population has schizophrenia. This rate increases significantly if you happen to be a relative of a person with schizophrenia. Closer the relationship that you share with a person with schizophrenia, higher the chances of getting this condition. Therefore, schizophrenia has a high familial tendency. There may also be other causes for schizophrenia, such as pre-existing brain changes in the structure or in the chemical nature of the brain, especially to do with the dopaminergic neurotransmitter system, which shows an overactivity in the brain of schizophrenic patients. So what are the signs and symptoms of schizophrenia? The main symptoms of schizophrenia may be characterized as thought interference phenomena, wherein the patient feels as though his or her thoughts are being interfered with or are being projected out to the world or shared with each other. The patient may also feel as though his or her own thought is being heard as an echo. Delusions of passivity, that is, feeling as though the body is under some external control, is also a feature. Hearing voices or auditory hallucinations, as they are called, is also very common, and this may occur in two forms. One is running commentary type of auditory hallucinations, wherein the patient hears a commentary, like in a cricket match, about all the actions he or she performs. Or it could be third person voices, wherein two voices may discuss about the patient in third person. There may also be disorders in thought, as well as catatonic behavior, wherein the patient may maintain the same posture for several hours. Negative symptoms characterized by a lack of will to perform any activity, social isolation, or speaking very little or not at all may also be seen. Mood and behavioral changes, such as laughing to oneself or talking to oneself, or being excessively suspicious and disorganized in speech and behavior, are also seen in schizophrenia. Irrationality of thought and action and increased irritability and anger may also be features of this condition. There is also a loss of insight, in the sense that the patient does not recognize that he or she is mentally ill and requires treatment. Which brings us now to the treatment of this complex condition. Remember that the first episode of schizophrenia may occur in the second and third decade of life, that is to say from 18 to 25 years of age. Sooner the treatment is initiated in this condition, the better is the overall prognosis. Initially, admission into a psychiatric inpatient unit and medication may be required. Baseline blood tests such as liver function tests, kidney tests, and white cell count may be required, along with an electrocardiogram. Treatment with antipsychotic medications such as risperidone, olanzapine, or aripiprazole is also required. Patients and their relatives often ask me how long they need to continue this treatment, and also if there can be a permanent cure for this illness. There is no easy answer to this question, because the prognosis and the overall course of the illness changes from person to person. Some patients may have only one episode of illness, whereas usually it is a case of relapse of the illness, wherein there may be several episodes that require ongoing treatment. Rather than complete cure of the illness, the main aim of treatment should be to control the signs and symptoms and to integrate the patient socially as well as vocationally. Family role is very important in the management of schizophrenia. If you happen to be a family member caring for a person with schizophrenia, you can begin by educating yourself about the illness. Provide the patient with support in terms of managing the activities of daily living and looking for jobs. Monitor the compliance with treatment and make sure that the patient is taking the treatment regularly. It is also wise to keep the tablets with yourselves and supervise the intake of tablets. As I mentioned before, due to the loss of insight, the patient may refuse to take the treatment. Therefore, treatment monitoring is very important. Please also bear in mind that about 10% of patients with schizophrenia commit suicide. Therefore, it is very important to keep all the tablets out of reach so that during an acute episode of the illness, the patient does not take an overdose of the tablets. Another very important thing to bear in mind is not to resort to any high expressed emotions. That is to say, not to victimize or blame the patient or compare him or her with his or her siblings. Doing so may result in the relapse of the illness and a worse overall prognosis. Also, make sure that the patient is not abusing any substances such as alcohol or smoking or cannabis or any other substances that may worsen the overall prognosis of the condition. In the Indian context, marital prospects and marriage are very important. My advice to the families with people with schizophrenia is to make a full disclosure to the other party about the pre-existing illness and its treatment. This is to avoid any further misunderstandings or problems later on in the life of the patient or his or her partner. Also, it is important that the patient continues to receive support from the family, including his or her partner, so that the illness can be better controlled. To conclude, please remember that even though schizophrenia is a complex and complicated condition, treatment is available and the signs and symptoms can be controlled and the patient can live as normal a life as possible through social and vocational integration. Thank you for watching this video. Namaste.